So let us continue with our lesson, and today we'll be learning about the insert option in our SQL select statement. So we'll select some of the record from one table and insert it to another table. So let's go and start. For that, what we'll do is we'll create a new table first. Just create a new table. I have already created a table group over here, and I'll just create a new table. And let me copy this name from here and just paste it over here. And which I'll give a table option over here. So that demo DML table, and I will just give a label of a demo DML table, and I'm giving a hard coded over here. But if you are in actual environment, you should always create a label for your table. So that should be fine. And I think we don't need to change any other option for now. And I think that should be fine. Okay, let's just create a simple table and just save this one. And what we'll do is we will be inserting some of the data to this table, so we will need a sum field. So why not we go to our table from here, and let's create a let's select a cells table for now, and we will add some of the field from our cells table to our demo table. So what I will select from here is let me select a customer account. So let's select a cust account from here and just drag and drop it over here, and that will add a new field for us. And another one is let me take a delivery date, customer account delivery date, and what I'll also take is a delivery term. Let me take a delivery term 3 and at least a 5. I think 5 should be enough. So another one would be delivery name. So let me take whether we have any delivery name. And finally, we'll select a sales ID. So let me select a sales ID. Yeah, okay, so we have a 5 field over here, and we will inserting from our sales table to our ZDemo DML table. So what we'll do is now we'll go to our class over here. Let's go to the view code over here. And let me create a new method over here, and I'll just call it as a insert data. So we'll be using that one. Just save it, and I will take a table of a table variable of a sales table, and I'll just copy this one and just give a same name over here, and I'll just make it a lowercase s. So that should be fine. And we also need to take another table, so I will take a get demo. Sorry, get demo. What the table name? Oh, yeah, this is get demo DML table. So just copy this one and I'll just paste it over here, and just make a variable from here. I'll just call it as a demo DML table. So we have a two table variable over here. One is a sales table. One is our demo DML table. So what we'll do now is let me minimize all of this, make me a little bit smaller. So what I will do now is I will select some of the, we need to select 5 field. So we need to select from a sales table. So I'll just say select just a 5 field. Instead of selecting all of the table field, we'll just select some of the field only. So sales ID, comma, we have a delivery name. Just copy this and just paste it. And also we have a delivery term. Just copy this and paste it over here. Just don't forget to add a comma in the middle. So delivery date. Just paste it over here. And finally we have a cust account. Just copy this and paste it over here. And I'll just say from. So I hope you already know how to select the table, right? Table data, right? So we just select sales ID, delivery name, delivery term, delivery date, cust account from where you want to select. It's a sales table, and some sales table where. So let's just select from one single sales ID. So let me go over here and select one sales ID. So let me select this one. Just copy this one and let's go back and see where sales. Table, yeah, the sales ID, yeah, sales ID is equals to and our sales ID over here. That's it. We have a select statement, and this will select our first record of our sales ID with belonging to 000727. So we have a table buffer over here for a sales ID, a sales table. So this sales table will contain a data and buffer data for our this selection. So next step is that we need to insert the data to our Jet Demo sales table. So what we'll do is we will just set it as begin, and that's this is begin. And after we begin the TTS, we'll just select the demo GML table, and that sales ID is equals to what we'll say is sales table dot sales ID. Yeah, sales table. Sorry, not the sales ID, should be sales, not the sales group, it should be sales ID. And we also have a demo DML table dot another one is delivery, yeah, delivery date. Okay, let us give a delivery name first. Delivery name is equals to, let's select the sales table dot delivery name. Yeah, delivery name. And the third one is a demo DML table dot delivery date, right? DLI delivery date is equals to sales table dot delivery date. Yeah, okay. And we have a demo DML table dot one is another one is a delivery term, DLV term. Each equals to sales table dot DLV term. Yeah, that one. And finally, we have one option which is a demo. Sorry, DEMO DML table dot cust account. Right, cust account is equals to sales table dot cust account. Yeah, that should be fine. And finally, we need to insert it. So where we want to insert is a demo DML table dot we have a method to insert. So just select the insert method from here, and that should be fine. And just close it, terminate it, and we will say TTS commit. So we'll just use a TTS commit, and that should be fine. And what we'll do now is we'll just save this one, and let us go to our run method. So in the run method, we need to add that method, we need to call that method. So insert data, we need to call over here, and that should be okay. And let's run it. So when we run it, I think we have a data already. So let's go to our table over here, and let me open this table. Yeah, so we already have one row inserted over here, which is from sales ID, this one, and delivery term, and the delivery name, delivery date, and also a cust account. So that's it, how we can select the record from one table and insert it to our table. So we are just selecting a one record. You can also use a while select to select the multiple record and insert it to our table over here. So on the next lecture, we'll go and see how to use a while loop and loop through and insert it to our table over here. So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, have a great day.